It's been several months since Mass Effect Legendary Edition was released, and by now you might be looking for something else to play, trying to fill the void in your sad Mass Effectless life. In this video, I'm going to recommend 10 games you should play when you're ready for a break from the Mass Effect trilogy. Most of them are RPGs, some new, and some much older. Keep watching to see what made the list. What's up, everyone? Big Dan here. Before we begin, you should know I have over 100 Mass Effect Trilogy videos on my channel, including hidden scenes, rare choices, lore videos, and guides. So if you want to see more Mass Effect, hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications so you don't miss any new videos. Also, I've put links in the description to my PC gaming setup, so if you're looking for some new gear for yourself, you can check that out. Without further ado, let's dive right in. Number 1. Dragon Age Origins. There is no better place to start after finishing Mass Effect than diving into its sister franchise, Dragon Age. The first game in the series, Origins, is widely regarded as the best one, no shade to Inquisition. You'll immediately recognize that classic BioWare DNA in this game, a compelling story, great companions, and lots of choices. Some of your choices even have ripple effects in subsequent games, just like Mass Effect, albeit not quite as extensive. One of the most impressive parts of this game is the origin stories. Based on your class and racial choices in character creation, you'll play through an entirely different 1 to 2 hour prologue sequence. And this isn't like Cyberpunk 2077, where you play a 20-minute intro and then the life paths are largely irrelevant. Your background is frequently referenced in dialogue throughout the game and can even give you unique quest choices.
Exile, you are not to show your face here again. I have enough crime to deal with, I shouldn't have to dump you back in the deep roads.
Oh, and by the way, there are six, that's right, six different origin stories. It's insane the amount of work that BioWare must have put in to create all this unique content and variation. The main drawback to this game is the combat, which can feel clunky and outdated, although some people really like it. It sought to mix old-school real-time with pause strategy games like Baldur's Gate with more contemporary action titles. While I'm not a huge fan of the combat, it's worth sticking it out simply because the rest of the game is so incredible. All in all, Dragon Age Origins is hands down one of the best role-playing experiences in video game history. The amount of dialogue options, quest choices, and character backgrounds allows you to really get into character and forge your own story. It also offers insane replayability. I highly recommend DAO. Number 2. The Outer Worlds. This was probably the first really good space RPG to come out since the Mass Effect trilogy wrapped in 2012. Seriously, why aren't there more space RPGs? Haven't you devs made enough Sword and Shield fantasy games?
Fuck you.
Created by the folks who made Fallout New Vegas, The Outer Worlds offers a similar RPG experience in space. It's a really fun game with lots of choices and consequences. There are lots of planets to explore, quests to pursue, and quirky characters to talk to. It's also just stunningly beautiful to look at, with its rich, exaggerated color palette and art style. The dialogue is pretty funny in this game, not laugh-out-loud funny, but more like dry humor that will produce a couple of chuckles. But that humorous tone also comes with a cost when the game tries to be more serious, which isn't very often, mind you. It's like, bro, you've been making puns and jokes in every single conversation in this game, and now you want me to take you seriously? It's like a stand-up comedian trying to tell you to go vote or something. Good luck with that. When it comes to writing and character development, The Outer Worlds is considerably weaker than the Mass Effect trilogy, so don't set your expectations too high in that regard. But overall, it's a really fun sci-fi RPG that is absolutely worth playing. Number 3. Mass Effect Andromeda. Y'all knew I had to put another Mass Effect game on this list. I mean, if you're done with Legendary Edition, it makes sense to try out Andromeda, right? This game was torn apart by critics and fans when it was released in 2017, and it's definitely a considerable step down from the OG trilogy. That being said, Andromeda is quite fun and does have its shining moments. I have a full review exploring all aspects of gameplay and story, which I'll link in the description if you want to check that out. So play it for yourself and see if you enjoy it. Just don't expect the same level of quality that we got in the original trilogy. Number 4. Dragon Age Inquisition. In many ways, this is my favorite Dragon Age game. The combat and exploration are much more fluid and modern feeling, and BioWare offers us a big, beautiful game world, or BBGW, to explore. Inquisition also has a stellar cast of companions and side characters with interesting backstories and dialogue. There are 9 companions in your squad, plus three advisors and a plethora of side characters. You could seriously spend hours in this game just walking around and talking to people if you desire, not to mention the typical BioWare romance options.
Is something the matter? Ah!
Oh, for fuck's sake.
However, all this modernization left behind some elements from Origins that are sorely missed. In particular, dialogue choices suffer when compared to the first game, most likely due to a voiced protagonist. I always find it difficult to really get into character in Dragon Age Inquisition, especially with the whole cliche Chosen One style narrative that is forced down your throat. There are also way too many filler quests and fetch quests in this game. You can skip most of them, but unfortunately, because of the level and power requirements for the main quest line, you will eventually end up doing some BS content just to unlock the next story mission. It's an unfortunate design choice that drags down an otherwise phenomenal game. Still, the good in Dragon Age Inquisition far outweighs the bad, and I highly recommend you check out this game. Number 5. Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic. KOTOR is a classic for a reason. It's simply a great game. The combat and controls are a little janky by modern standards, but it's still incredibly fun. You play as an amnesiac Jedi, that old trope again, searching the galaxy for the location of a powerful ancient weapon and dodging your Sith enemies along the way, while also slowly uncovering the true source of your own power. And it's a BioWare game, so of course there are great companions.
You know another way to get a wife? But yes, that's when I met her.
One is even voiced by the same guy who did Caden Olenko in Mass Effect. And yes, Karth O'Nassi is just as annoying as Caden. Actually, he's probably more annoying now that I think of it. BioWare also gives the player lots of choices and consequences, even to the point of completely going over to the dark side, which is refreshing considering that this isn't even an option in more recent EA Star Wars games, which force you to be the good guy. Plus, it's Star Wars, bruh. What's not to love? Go play KOTOR. Number 6. Wasteland 3. This is a squad-based, post-apocalyptic, tactical RPG with turn-based combat, lots of branching paths with major choices and consequences, a robust skill system, and multiple endings. If this sounds great to you, then you'll love Wasteland 3 as much as I do. It's a fantastic role-playing game that gives a similar feeling experience to RPGs of the 1990s without the tedious aspects and unintuitive user interface. Based on the way I described it, you might think this is a relatively older game, but it's actually the newest one on this list, having come out in August 2020. For players who have never tried an isometric or tactical RPG, Wasteland 3 is the best introduction to that style of game, in my opinion. The combat is simple to understand and fun to play, the dialogue and choices offer great role-playing opportunities and replayability. Also, the writing is very funny and wacky at times.
Jesus, you're not one of those, are you? Fucking simps are always talking about how synths are sentient. They have feelings. Bullshit.
Go check out Wasteland 3. Number 7. Metro Exodus. This is the first game on the list that isn't an RPG, but I still think a lot of you will really enjoy it. Exodus is one of my all-time favorite games. It's a post-apocalyptic first-person shooter set in Russia. But this isn't a typical FPS like Call of Duty. It's much more story-driven, and even presents some light narrative choices that will impact the game's ending. Exodus also has a great exploration element with multiple open world maps to venture through. As for gameplay, it's as much a survival game as it is a shooter. Conservation of resources, such as ammo, gas mask filters, and healing supplies are vital to staying alive, and you'll oftentimes want to take a stealth approach simply to conserve resources. The stealth elements are simple but fleshed out and well done. You can perform silent takedowns, turn off lamps to hide in the shadows, disable traps, throw tin cans to create distractions, and use silence weapons to eliminate enemies without drawing attention. Even if you only play RPGs, I still recommend trying Metro Exodus because you might really enjoy it and expand your own interest in the process. Number 8. Fallout New Vegas. Staying on the theme of post-apocalyptic games, let's talk about this early 2010s classic. Fallout New Vegas is a classic RPG for a reason. It has many choices and consequences, tons of fun and interesting side quests, as well as bizarre and wacky characters in true Obsidian fashion. It's straight up unbelievable that this game was developed in 18 months, which honestly feels like a miracle. I could go on and on about Fallout New Vegas, but I won't. You really just have to experience it for yourself. Number 9. Deus Ex Human Revolution. This is a cyberpunk stealth slash action game with RPG elements. There is a robust skill tree with lots of game-changing abilities to explore, dialogue choices, speech checks, and even some story choices as well. The game focuses heavily on artificial augmentation of humans, and I'm not talking about boob jobs. I'm talking about bionic limbs that allow you to punch through walls and pick up freaking vending machines, or invisibility cloaks, and the Icarus landing system, which allows you to jump off high places and land gently on the ground. This is primarily a stealth game. You can go guns blazing, but it's much more difficult and less rewarding. You die with only a few gunshots and gain less XP from killing when compared to taking a silent approach. There is also an achievement for completing the game without killing anyone, with the exception of a few janky boss fights. I'm doing my second playthrough of Human Revolution right now, and I'm having a blast. So go check this one out. Number 10, Jade Empire. Last but not least, we have this underappreciated gem, no pun intended, from BioWare. Jade Empire was the studio's first truly original RPG, since their past games were based on Star Wars and Dungeons & Dragons. The game is set in a fictional place called, you guessed it, Jade Empire, which is loosely based on ancient China. The combat features a mixture of hand-to-hand, melee, and magic. I guess you could call it magic. It's pretty janky from a combat standpoint, but as usual, that's not the main draw of BioWare games. Jade Empire has an excellent story, interesting setting, companions, romance, great writing, and humor. You know the drill. This is a BioWare game. If you enjoy BioWare games like Mass Effect, you'll probably love Jade Empire. So go check it out. So there you have it. 10 games to play when you're done with Mass Effect Legendary Edition. If you like this video, be sure to subscribe to Big Dan Gaming for more Mass Effect and RPG videos. I'm also on Instagram, so go follow me at Big Dan Gaming. Until next time, this has been Big Dan. I should go.